What's up guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to show you guys my updated wash and go, and these are all of the products that I'm going to be using. So to condition my hair, I like to use the OGX coconut curls conditioner, and I like to leave a little bit of this in my hair before I come out of the shower just because it makes it more manageable. Next up, I like to use the curls creme brule as my moisturizer, and I find that my wash and goes last longer when I use a cream based moisturizer. So as my styler, I use the curls goddess curls, and my hair just really needs a gel to make my curls last longer and to really make my curls pop. And lastly, I like to use the curls blueberry bliss control paste for my edges as well as all over my hair for popping curls. And no, this video is not sponsored, I just get the most consistency with these products. So this is my hair straight out of the shower, and as you can see, my hair is soaking wet, and that's the best way to apply a product to your hair, well, at least for mine, and the hairdresser said that as well. So I'm starting off with the curls creme brule, and this is basically how much product I use on each section of my hair, and that's what you call a quarter size amount, well, us naturals, but it really ain't no quarter size amount. And I'm just gonna really smooth that into my hair, and I'm gonna do this on both sides. I just want to make sure that my hair is moisturized before it kind of dries up on me. And I'm just going to really smooth that into my hair and make sure that my hair is nice and, you know, moisturized and getting all that goodness in it. So now I'm going to divide my hair into a total of four sections, but I'm just going to start off with these two sections right here, starting in the back. And I apply more of the creme brule because my hair is super dry and it just needs a lot of product to stay moisturized. So I'm just going to make sure that I get that all over my strands, and breaking them up into little sections like this will definitely get your hair popping. But as you can see, my hair is kind of dry, and I was at my boyfriend's house this time and I didn't have a spray bottle, so I'm being real ghetto and putting my hair in a cup to get it all moisturized with water. And then I'm going in with the goddess curls on top of it and really just locking in all that moisture and setting my curls with this gel right here. And this is really going to make my curls pop and, you know, get really defined. So as you can see, I'm kind of doing the praying method, is it the hand praying method, where I'm just really smoothing it into my hair. And I'm going to do this also to this section right here, applying the creme brule, and then on top of that, I'm layering the goddess curls. So once this side is complete, you can see the difference. One side is a lot frizzier than the other. And yeah, I'm just gonna do the same thing to the next side. As you can see, my hair got dry, so I'm applying a little bit of the creme brule as well as some water in my hand just to really, you know, make my hair smooth and get rid of that frizz and dryness. So again, I'm just really smoothing that into my hair, you know, shingling it through. And I'm pretty much gonna do the same thing to the last section. And once that's complete, I'm just going to scrunch my hair, and this is also going to make my curls more defined. And as you can see, I have a little middle part going on, and I'm not really feeling middle parts. I just like my hair to go wherever it wants to go. So I'm just flicking my hair all the way back, applying more product, some water as you can see, and it just went all over me. Wow. So yeah, I'm just applying some water and some product and just smoothing my hair back so it doesn't have that straight middle part, that line of demarcation right there. And yeah. So you can see that this gets really messy, like look at my shirt guys. So onto my edges, I'm just going to take the Blueberry Bliss Control Paste and put a little bit of that on my edges and just really smooth them down. I love how this makes my hair super shiny. And I'm also going to put it throughout the length of my hair. And as you can see, my hair got more shiny and more popping. Like, look at that. And then, of course, I'm going to take my toothbrush, my handy dandy toothbrush, and just smooth down my edges. So once I do that, I'm just going to shake my hair from side to side. And this is going to clump the curls together. And I'm going to let my hair air dry for about, I don't know, however long it takes to air dry. And then before I go to bed, I just like to take my hair into a high ponytail. You can either use a satin scrunchie, but I like to use my head tie. And I kind of just wrap it around the back of my head and then pull it into like a ponytail. And I really love the volume that this gives my hair. And if you follow me on Snapchat, you probably see me like this every single day. So this is the next day. This is how my curls are looking. As you can see, my hair is fully dried and my curls are looking delicious. So I'm about to take my hair down and just fluff it out and kind of raise the roots of my hair to, you know, lay it how I want to lay it and create some more volume. So as you can see, I'm just pulling my hair apart and shaking it and everything just so it can lay how it wants to lay naturally, because that's the kind of look that I like now. So yeah, I decided to just put my hair to one side but without the part, and then I'm going to get my edges again, lay them. So these are my final results. I've been doing this to my hair a lot lately. You guys have been asking me for updated wash and go routine, so here it is. I hope you guys enjoyed. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and I'll see you guys all in the next video. Deuces.